So today we are taking a journey through the airport, and we're going to take the very same journey that a disabled customer is going to take. How does that all work?
So the customer's dropped off, they'll come here, there's somewhere for them to sit down. When they arrive here at the airport and they need assistance, they press the buzzer on the yellow unit. So we've got two check-in areas for our customers who require assistance. We occupy the whole building here now. So what we felt was that when a customer travels, we want it to be inclusive, and we want it to be part of the journey for them that everyone else would have. So check-in at home, check-in online, it's entirely up to the customer. They'll arrive here in Zone A. First and foremost, you're asked to speak to the British Airways member of staff and check you in, make sure you've got the seating you want, make sure you know where your flight's going from, deal with all that side of it. We then hand you over to our colleagues at Wilson James who are on the desk next to you, and you're free to make your own way. Or you can take an option, assistance with the help of the colleagues. When the customer comes through security, if they're on a wheelchair, they can remain in the wheelchair if they want to, or they can get out and walk through the archway and go on the other side. When you exit security, this is the area you come into. You walk straight into duty free. Now for a neurodiverse customer, that can be a real issue. Obviously with the sound, the sights, the smells, the intense lighting. Just have a look online. Get to know whether your local airport has a quiet room. This is the Litchfield suite. So a customer who requires assistance through the airport, isn't able to self-mobilise, isn't in their own wheelchair, this is where they'll be brought to. So Wilson James, after they've checked the customer in, would bring them through security. They would be accompanied all the way through, all the way down here. Now, the assistance provider will take a customer to a lounge rather than bring them here if they have entitlement for lounge access instead. So we do it, Gatwick do it. They will hand out a pager. So the customer, once they're in here, some customers may think, oh, actually, it's not too far to the pilot's bar. I'm going to go and have a drink. And yep, they'll make their way there and go and do it. And the pager will buzz when it's time for the customer to come back here to collect their assistance to take them through to the departure, to the aircraft departure. When you come to the gate, obviously, as we've said already, if we can make sure as soon as it says go to gate, the customer goes to the gate. One of the most important things is we will offer pre-board. You'll be let into this area where we are right now, and the gate team will let our accessibility customers and families, to be fair, go first. So a turn of an aircraft is the aircraft coming onto stand, disembarking, customers getting back on again, and departure. That is known as an aircraft turn. We will turn an aircraft in 45 minutes, okay, on a short haul aircraft. This space here is what you have to get out of your wheelchair, to transfer into the net, into the onboard wheelchair and be lifted on. If the customer arrives during boarding, so they miss pre-board and it's like it is now, we've all been there, then the customer would be asked to wait till the end and would board last, because we can't try and get an aisle chair on and off because nobody else can board while the aisle chair is on this aisle because it's blocking the aisle. Okay? If there's anything we can ever do to give you advice about what would you do with this, what would you do with that, we certainly can give you a steer in the right direction.